and the rain will fall. And the earth for the nabat to come out, and the vegetation will come out. And the people, this is because of what they see, they believe in him. Wal'iyadu billah. He is a big liar, and this is one of the reasons why his name Ad-Dajjal. He will be killed at the Babul Lud. He will be killed at the Babul Lud. At the Babul Lud, which, as the ulama mentioned, it is in Palestine. That what will be appearing to look like the fire, it is not the fire, but rather it is a cold, fresh water. Cool, fresh water. And to believe all of this, that it is to be existing. It is in reality. He will misguide those whom he is calling to his to have rububiyyah. Yes, he misguides people. I like that part. Very good. He will emerge between Sham and Iraq. Between Sham and Iraq. In a pathway between Sham and Iraq. Yes, brother. هذا ذكرت. Has been mentioned. Meaning it has been already mentioned. Right, the hadha aydan qad dhukirat. That has been also mentioned. I believe that Abu, somebody around here said it. That he was shakhs, he was haqiqi. Na'am. It's not a majaz, it's not a metaphor, neither. Na'am, Sulaiman.
It will come like a prophet.
No, he will claim more than a prophet. He will claim more than a prophet. Muhammad. I'm sorry? No, I can't hear what you say. Say it one more time, a little louder. No, you gotta listen. If you want me to hear you, you gotta speak a little louder, just like I'm kind of sometimes raising my voice so you can hear me well. No, everybody will see him. Tayyib, let's, inshallah, wrap it up briefly by reading their explanation of Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad al-Madkhali, rahimahullah. He mentioned, هَذَا حَقٌ, that the coming of the Dajjal, it is the truth. And he mentioned, خروج مسيح الدجال في آخر الزمان ثابت ثابت بالنصوص السنة المطهرة. He say, indeed, the appearance of the Dajjal in the last hour, it is something that is affirmed from the pure Sunnah, from the pure Sunnah. He say, وأن إنكاره أهل البدع والضلالة. That this is something that the people of misguidance and the people of deviation, they have yani denied and refused to believe in. He say, فَهُوَ خَارِجٌ وَيُجُبُّ الْأَرْضِ كُلَّهَا إِلَّا مَكَّةَ وَمَدِينَةَ. And he will be putting forth his feet on every single land except Mecca and Medina. And Medina. And he say, فَإِنَّ عَلَيْهَا Malaika, because you have angels that are guarding Mecca and Medina. فَلَا يَدُخُلُ مَكَّةَ وَلَا يَدُخُلُ مَدِينَ. He will not neither enter Mecca nor Medina. He say, وَتَرَجُّفُ الْمَدِينَ بِأَهْلِهَا فَيَخْرُجُ مَنْ كَانَ خَبِيثًا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا تَبِعًا لِلدَّجَّالِ. He say that Medina and likewise Mecca will shake to the point that the khabith, meaning the evil people, will be spilled out. Right? And they will go and follow Ad-Dajjal. And they will go and follow Ad-Dajjal. So this, barakallahu feekum, here, this individual, they were leaving in Makkah and Medina. Na'am, alhamdulillah, Makkah and Medina, they are the best places of the earth. Huh? Without a doubt. But that doesn't guarantee a person to be upon the truth. A person, barakallahu feekum, walillah alhamdu wal min, to be upon the truth, you got to recognize two things. You got to recognize the truth, and you got to recognize the people of the truth. Once you recognize the truth, you cling onto it. You hold on to it. Addu alayha bin nawajiz. Bite down to it with your molar teeth. Number two, after you upon the truth, you gotta be with the people of the truth. You cannot be upon the truth and be away from the people of the truth. This is impossible. It will only increase you in weakness. It will only increase you in being down in your belief in your incorrectness. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa kunu ma'a sadiqin. O you who believe in Allah, believe the right belief, but be with those who are truthful. So you all remember, barakallahu feekum, the statement of Sharabi hafidhahullah in the very previous classes. He say arafna, and he mentioned the statement of who? Sufyan al-Thawri, ahsanta, very good. He say we knew people, they used to be speaking bad about the people of innovation. They went with them, wasaru ma'ahum, and they be just like them. So it is important, alhamdulillah, for the people of the sunnah to be with the people of the sunnah. And to be patient with the people of the sunnah. Because if you go with the people of innovation, you're going to be patient with their innovation. A person going to start talking about Tijani or Murid or Sufiya, you're not going to get up and tell him, hey, you are lying. You're going to still sit where you are sitting. So you've been patient with it. And why can't you be patient with the people of the sunnah? If you're going to be patient with batil, you will be patient with batil. You will be. So he mentioned حفظه الله ولا يدخل المدينة into the Medina. وكما ورد في النصوص الكثير وصفه بأنه أعور العين اليمين ومكتوب بين عينيه كافر أي كافر يقرأه كل مؤمن سواء كان قارئا أو غير قارئ. He mentioned that it will, from the description of the Dajjal, as we all mentioned, alhamdulillah, is that the Dajjal will be blinded on the right eye, and it will be written on his forehead the word, these three letters, kafir, meaning the word kafir, that every single believer will be able to read it, whether he is illiterate or he is literate. He said, يَقْرَأُهُ وَيَعْرِفُهُ. Not only he will read it, but he will be aware of him. Not only he will be able to read it, but he will be able to recognize him. And then narrate the another thing that maybe we didn't mention was about whoever want to be saved from the Dajjal, أن يقرأ إيش؟ مش يسي؟ ها؟ يعني a little louder. The ustaz will not agree with that. Abdullah. ها؟ سورة الكهف. كهف. هكذا. Ustaz. No. The surah, the name. سورة الكهف. Right? But here, in the narration, it talks about what? إيش؟ ها؟ In that hadith we read, it and mentioned the 10. It only say the beginning. Fawatih. He called it the Fawatih Suratul Kahfi. The opening, the beginning of Suratul Kahfi. Yes, some other narration mentioned the 10 verses. Ahsant.
So therefore, Hafidh رحمه الله he mentioned ويعرفه and they will know it. وهو من الأمور التي ابتليت هذه أم به هذه الأمة. And it is, meaning the Dajjal, it is one of the issues, it is one of the things that Allah has put this Ummah upon, a trial. And we understand what was the meaning of the trial. From who? From who? What scholar? From who? We read the name of the scholar that clarified to us what was the meaning of that ibtila, that trial. Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabiri, hafizahullah. That's why it's good to write, though. It's good to write. Sometime when, let's say here, I'm going to show you my page. Let's say, alhamdulillah, this is my copy. But when in this point, I underline it. Underline it, and not only underline, took few minutes to memorize it. Let's say now, alhamdulillah, if I would have died, my son will, inherited the book. Now, this point right here will be, this book is important, but this line is very important too. I'm coming. Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabir, hafidhahullah, he mentioned, imtahana, he say, فَيَبْعَثُهُ اللَّهُ إِمْتِحَانًا لِلْعِبَادِ حَتَّى يُمَيِّزُ الصَّادِقُ فِي إِيمَانِهِ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِ. He said that the sending or the appearance of the Dajjal, he said Allah has made it a trial for the believers. إِمْتِحَان حَتَّى يُبَيِّنُ أَوْ يُمَيِّزُ, until it will be a criterion between the mu'min that is sadiqun fi imanihi, the believer that is truthful in his belief, from the one that is a liar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the Quran mentioned about certain things being a trial. Alif lam mim, ahasiba an-nasu an yutraku an yaqulu ash amanna wa hum la yuftanun. That do the people think that they will say they believe and they will not be put into trial? وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Straight up, just like this, that those who barak Allah fikum, they will be upon the truth, and those who will be upon falsehood. Those who will be upon the tawheed, and those who will be upon the shirk, those who will be upon sunnah, and those who will be upon innovation. It has to be a tamiz. It has to be barakallahu fik, a criterion. You can waltz around. You can one leg here, one leg there. It's impossible. Huh? Right? It's impossible, barakallahu fik. Somebody, what was the verse yesterday? Wa ma ja'ala Allahu. Ahsanta. Surah. I heard it here. I heard it from this land, right? Don't ask Ismail or Muhammad. Huh? He say Ahzab. Anybody, you agree? Okay. Ismail, you agree? La huh? La adri. What was you saying?
It's the one you mentioned yesterday. That's
Surah Ahzab. Now, Jazakallah khairan. Inshallah, that's a very beautiful ayah too. Alhamdulillah. So here, the Shaykh Hafidhahu Rahimahullah, he mentioned, and in the important point here, he mentioned here, is likewise wa khurujuhu alamatun min alamat as-sa'a al-kubra, that the appearance of the Dajjal, it is one of the major signs. It is one of the major signs among other major signs of the establishment of the hour. We know, barakallahu fikum, they are from the signs of the hour, as Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, will ask the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, mata sa'a, when is the hour? And he answered him,